In this video, we'll see something related to users. Now, there are different types of users in a project. It can be testers, developers, project managers, or the client. So every user has different permissions and different authentications. Who will be doing this task? This task of creation or assigning some permissions will be done by the site admin. So let us see the different tasks practically. How do we create a users? How do we assign users to a project? And how do we activate and deactivate the users? So let us see that practically. Now let us see the third part, that is creating different types of users and how do we assign those users to a particular project. Now I'll just click on this site users tab. And if you observe, these are the left hand side. On the left hand side, these are the users which are already created. ALM admin, John, Mercy, Pavan and Rita. This I have created previously. By default, I had only ALM admin because when I was installing the server, I required at least one admin part here. Now, let's see how do we create a new user. So on the top, if you see this icon, it says new user. I'll click on this new user and I'll get a dialog box here. In this dialog box, you can just add the details about the user. Let's say I'll add the username as Robert, full name as Robert Kia, and the email ID if you want, you can enter, phone number, descriptions, and simply you can click on OK. So make sure at least you enter the full name and the username. These are required. I mean, you have to use it so it's easy to distinguish, because if you see on the left hand side, username, there's a column. Password, there's a column, but whereas for email ID, phone number, there's no columns which are given. I'll simply click on this OK. And if you observe this name, which is given here as Robert, and Robert Kia is a full name which is given here. So on the right hand side, if you observe Robert, it is giving the user details, username, full name, status is given as active. By default, when you create a user, it is in the active mode. If you want, you can just deactivate that person. That person will no longer be able to use the projects part. Or else, if you want this Robert person to work for, let's say, 30 days, you can just give an activation date, that is deactivation date. You can click on this drop down. Exactly 30 days from today, that is 5/27, 27 is today's date. I can keep as 6/27, 2017, and I can just ask this person to get deactivated on this particular date. You can enter the email ID, the phone number, and the description part. Now, there is a very high possibility that this person, Robert, might be assigned to multiple projects. So if you click on this user projects, it will give you the list of all the domains and list of all the projects for which this person, Robert, is assigned. Right now, there is no domains and no project. So what I'll do is, I'll select the project from here. I'll click on this select projects. On the right hand side, these are the different domains which are given. I can just maximize this tourism. Why I'm getting this plus sign? Because I have only one project in this tourism, whereas there are no projects in the other parts. So I'll just select this project, that is Mercury Tours. I can just take on the left hand side. I'll just click on this place. So now Robert is a person who's assigned to this tourism domain and to the Mercury Tours project. And that's it. So this person is assigned. Let us see what is this person, that is Pavan, which is assigned. Pavan is also assigned for user project, that is tourism, Mercury Tours. If I check for Rita, if I check for John, if I check for ALM admin or Mercy. So if you see Mercy, it is not assigned. I can simply select this Mercury Tours and click on this place. Okay. Remember, these are the users. They are not the project administrators. So let me show you again. If I go back to this site projects, if I select this tourism domain, expand it to the Mercury Tours. On the right hand side, if you see, there's a project users and these are all the list of users. If you carefully observe on the right hand side, project administrators will be given the check mark, whereas the other people are the normal users. They'll be having a limited access to the project administration properties. So if you observe ALM admin, John and myself Pavan, these three candidates have been given as the project administrator part itself. So same part, you can also add the members from here. You can just click on this add. You can click on add from the users list. Right now the list is empty because all the users are available on this project itself, right? So I'll just simply click on this close. Now, if you think I don't want this Rita in my project, you can simply click on this remove button, remove users from project. It will ask you, are you sure that you want to remove Rita from the current project? I'll say yes, yes. Okay, and this person would be removed from this particular project itself. So I hope you have understood how to create different types of users, add those users to a project, and how do we delete users from the current project. That's all for this video.